Hello, welcome back. In the previous video, we discussed the key strategic decision of whether to adopt off-the-shelf pre-written packages for our management information systems or rather resort to bespoke development of custom-made applications. We emphasize that this strategic choice should be clearly differentiated from the more tactical decision of who will build the system if a bespoke development is chosen, which will be the subject of this video. Thus, in our clothing analogy, if we choose to have at least some of our clothes tailor-made, we would then have to decide whether to sew them ourselves or pay someone to do it for us. Thus, companies must decide whether to use internal company resources to tackle whichever bespoke development is carried out or subcontract or outsource that to external providers. This tactical decision will generally be taken based on tactical, not strategic, considerations. The key factors will generally be resource availability, cost, and future implications. Quite often, companies do not have internal resources, either volume-wise or skills-wise, to tackle substantial development projects that are likely to be one-offs. Thus, they resort to specialized consulting companies for the service. Costs are normally carefully considered. External companies impose a markup. However, they can sometimes reap economies of scale or specialization that render their total cost lower. On the other hand, companies want to retain internal control of the ad hoc development, reduce over-dependency from the consulting company, and ensure that the project conforms to the specificities. Thus, they often create joint teams, combining internal, technical, and business personnel with appropriate personnel from the consultancy. The option of subcontracting or outsourcing is not confined to software development work. Actually, a decision must be taken for each activity within the management information systems area, regarding whether to carry it out with internal or with external subcontracted or outsourced resources. Some companies have outsourced the whole management information systems department to specialized outsourcing companies. The salary differentials and increasing IS sophistication in countries such as India have led to a growing adoption of offshoring, meaning subcontracting information systems related work, whether development or otherwise, to companies or units located in low-cost countries. In a way, information systems offshoring follows the path initiated by manufacturing when it massively moved to places like China. Initially, the information systems related work being offshored was relatively low level. However, outsourcing hubs such as Bengaluru in southern India, or Bangalore as it was formerly called, have over time developed higher level capabilities. This represents a significant business opportunity, but it has also led to growing anxieties in countries such as the USA regarding the potential of significant job losses. Big, internationally competitive Indian software companies now vie for the largest information systems contracts worldwide. Besides, the main international Western consulting companies carry out a growing share of their labor-intensive activities, including increasingly research and development, through the subsidiaries they have set up in lower-cost countries. Companies must analyze the option of subcontracting for all its business areas, not just information systems. What makes the information systems activity particularly prone to subcontracting among service activities is its potential for delocalization through telecommunications. Most information systems-related activities can be carried out by subcontractors remotely over telecommunications networks, thus greatly facilitating outsourcing and specifically offshoring. This is starkly illustrated by the trend towards cloud computing, infrastructure as a service, and software as a service, which we shall discuss later on in this course. Outsourcing and offshoring are not trouble-free, however. Cultural barriers, time zone differentials, issues regarding data protection and confidentiality, and complex contractual and project management requirements are some of the hurdles faced by these approaches. Thus, companies must decide the extent to which they will subcontract or outsource their information systems related activities to external providers. The ability to decouple or delocalize these activities through telecommunication networks has facilitated outsourcing, and more specifically offshoring, even though these approaches must overcome significant difficulties. Let us now pose a few review questions before moving on to explore in the next video how management information systems are actually developed. Thank you. I will see you there.